Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. Today we'll be back on the Southeastern High Speed Route, and going to be doing one of the timetable scenarios for the route. Before we start, I'd like to give a shout out to James for supporting the channel. This time we are going to be driving the class 375. Don't worry, we will be doing more videos on the class 395, and I will be live streaming tonight, so hopefully you guys can join me for that. But I was thinking we would do this scenario over here, which is this one, London Charing Cross to Rainham. Take this Rainham service from Gravesend. Well, let's get started. Okay, there you go. Take this Rainham service from Gravesend. Okay, let's open the doors. Oops. Not. It would help if the master key was on. So let's do that. Just put this into neutral. Yeah, opening the doors when it's the master key's not in is not the smartest idea, is it? Headlights on, yep, there we go. Let's put the destination in. If I remember how to. So, we need, well, I'm guessing Rainham is on here. It's 25, so let's go down. Oops, that's too much. There we go. Confirm location. Have that work? Yes, that's nice. Yeah, this train is pretty much like the class 377. I'm not too sure exactly what the difference between a class 375 and a 377, but it's pretty similar. But I do like the livery of the Southeastern in the dark blue with the sky blue doors. Really, really nice livery. I will try and make the old class 375 livery, which is white and green and white and yellow one. I have seen someone do it, but I'm not very good at making liveries, so I will try my best and do one. I didn't even see someone do a GWR livery with this, the class 377, which obviously runs on the GWR line, so and they made a really good one. I don't think I can make it as good as that, but I'll attempt it and you guys can let me know what you think of it. I mean, even if I spent an hour making the livery, it probably won't be any good because I lack any skill. I mean, if I was any good with liveries, then I probably would have made myself some for Train Simulator. Okay, So I did post a video yesterday on the Class 395. Kind of like a shuttle service between London, King's Cross to Ipswich International. I'm back. Go check it out if you haven't done so. I mean, I can definitely see myself playing this route a lot more than other routes because you actually have, I think, 51 miles on this route to drive and two different trains, passenger service and high speed service. So it's pretty good. And it does seem to run pretty decent, even on my computer, which is like 8 years old. Heard the AWS on this train, so that did scare me a little bit. I was like, what sound is that? It doesn't sound good. Will I do any? Probably not, because I just don't know how to drive a Class 66. Unless it tells me how to start it up and brake and all that, then I probably can do it, but I just don't know. I can't drive freight trains, unfortunately. I'm not a big fan of them either, so. Approaching Higham, platform 2. This is a service from London Charing Cross. I really hope they add the Chatham Main Line or something like that to Trains and World. I think then it would be amazing because we've got the Class 375. They can add the Class 465, which they're doing in the future. Slightly, but that's okay. This is a Southeastern service to Rainham. I believe we're going to Rainham. Yeah, a bit hilarious if we're not. I've been saying it the whole video. Not seen any Class 395s yet. minutes to go, so we need to arrive at Stroud, platform 1. I do believe we are slightly late though. I'm not too sure where this light's coming from. As you can see, we're still in the tunnel, but the cab is really bright now, so I find that a bit weird. It might be a bit of a glitch, which they're hopefully working on. Yeah, now it's fine because it's meant to be dark when we're in the tunnel, but anyways, really weird. Might be because my settings are quite low, that's probably why. Yeah, I should really slow down. We're nowhere near 15 miles an hour and I'm still at 40. And we're definitely going to be speeding. As we approach Stroud, this is Stroud, mind the gap between a train and platform edge. We're going to Rochester, not Rainham. I'm pretty sure that's correct. I'm not too sure why I said Rainham. Might have been another scenario that I found. I believe that line that goes straight ahead goes towards Maidenhead East and stuff like that, so. Thank you. is it just the new Rochester station? I was wondering that we were skipping the station and we're going to the old Rochester station, but this is the station that we're stopping at. Yeah, these passengers are still flying in the air, as you can see. Kind of funny. Building works in the background. There we go. Ooh, one more station. Chatham, platform 2. You know what? I don't even know what station is stopping at. First I thought it was Rainham, then I thought it was Rochester, so. I mean, it is 6 o'clock in the morning for those that. Of you are wondering, I've just woken up and gone to Trains and Locomotives too, so hopefully you won't mind me making all these mistakes. I'm guessing this is the old Rochester station. Still passengers seem to be wanting to fly in the air. They still haven't fixed that from the East Coast Street line and the Bakerloo line, so yeah. I mean, it can't be that hard to fix, surely. And the camera is still a bit wonky, as you can see. It just wants to like do what it wants. Yay. going up to 60 miles an hour, is it? No, 50. I mean, we'll still get a gold medal because we will. I mean, if we're going to be this way, then technically we shouldn't even be getting even a bronze. So we're actually going to Rainham. I completely don't know how this route actually works. I mean, I am from Northwest London anyway. I don't really travel at all in Southeast anyway. I've never been on a Southeastern service, and well, probably won't anytime soon because we're still in lockdown. And but yeah, my knowledge of this route is really bad, so I should really find those route maps and really see what position comes after each other, I guess. I didn't actually realise Rainham was after Gillingham, but then I realised that this route goes all the way to Faversham and we're not on the Chatham main line, so it is what it is. Should have one more stop. And we've got 25 mph speed limit just before we approach Rainham. Down now because you know what happened last time. now approaching Rainham, where this train hopefully should terminate. I mean, we're only like a minute late, so that's not too bad. Looks like we have made up some of the time back. Waiting for us. Well, waiting for the passengers on this train if they want to continue their journey. Got achievement unlocked, nice. Yeah, like I said, we got a gold medal, which is good. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like, share with your friends, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.